Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on my channel, Learn Programming with Me. You can search my channel on YouTube. You can subscribe my channel for updates. It contains 800 plus videos. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can calculate sum of diagonal of 2D array in Java. First of all, I am going to import a package whose name is util, and inside this package a class is available, scanner. So I am going to import this scanner class, that's why I have written this statement. Now I am going to define a class whose name is diagonal sum. Inside this class I am going to define main function. So main function will be containing the complete code. So this is 2D array declaration. I am going to read values of rows and column from user. Then variable s. Now to receive values from user, first I need to create instance of scanner class. With the help of this input, I can receive inputs from user. So first I am going to display the message enter row and column size. So row size will be stored inside R variable. And column size will be stored inside C variable. Now, memory allocation. So this way I have declared ARR 2D array of R C size. So this statement will display the message enter elements. Now entered elements will be received with the help of these nested loop. So line number 14 to 17 are responsible for reading input from user. After reading input, I have to calculate sum of diagonal elements. So again, I am going to use these nested loops. Here I am going to provide if condition if I double equals to j. So I is representing row index and j is representing column index. So if both are same, it means they are representing diagonal position. So here I can write s equals to s plus arr ij. So ij, if both are equal, it means diagonal elements are available. So those elements will be added into s variable. After completion of these nested loops, I can print sum on output screen. So this way I have implemented the complete code in front of you. There is one more logic available which will calculate sum of diagonal using single loop. So after execution of this code, I will also demonstrate you how you can do that. So first I am going to execute this code. Here you can see I am compiling and executing the code. I am entering row size as 3, 3. Make sure that row and column size must be equal, because diagonal is available in square matrix where rows and column size are equal. So I have to enter 9 elements. I have entered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. See the output. So diagonal elements, if we write 1, 2, 3, so in first row 1 is diagonal element, then 4, 5, 6, 5 is diagonal element, then 7, 8, 9, 9 is diagonal element. So 1 plus 5 plus 9 equals to 15. So this program is working properly. It is calculating proper diagonal sum. Now I am going to show you how you can calculate diagonal sum through one loop. So I am making this logic as comment. Now I am going to write another logic. Here you can see I am repeating only one loop and I am applying this logic S equals to S plus ARRII. You can see I am using same index for row and column. So if you see the diagonal position 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2. So if matrix is of 3 by 3, then diagonal positions indexes are same 0, 0, 1, 1 and 2, 2. So if I write same variable for row and column index, then they will automatically provide diagonal position. So with the help of this single loop, you can also calculate diagonal sum of 2D array. So I have saved the code. Now again, I am going to compile this code. I have updated code, that's why I am recompiling it. After successful compilation, I have to execute the code. Again, I am going to enter row and column size as 3, 3. And after that, I have to enter 9 elements. So you can see the output. Again, it is showing 15 as sum of diagonal. So it means there are two possible methods for calculating sum of diagonal of 2D array. You can use nested loops, as well as you can do that operation with the help of single loop. I hope you have understood whatever I have demonstrated you in this video. If you like this video, you can subscribe my channel. You can follow me on YouTube. Thank you for watching this video.